begins right from planting.
Susan Alanye, a worker under the NADS program, has her work cut out. For 3 years now, she has been focusing on banana multiplication from the Kawanda Research Center.
Bananas have started doing well in Amuru. It was a new crop and it took us time to convince farmers to start growing bananas.
It is a pilot project which has spread its tentacles to Padea district in the Acholi sub-region.
We thought we wouldn't get something good out of bananas.
Banana varieties for long spells have not thrived in northern Uganda, often a staple for the central and western regions.
They mature faster and even their sizes, they are not like the local variety, but it is a new variety, M9, M2, and we have Fiat 17.
These are known as hybrids or conventionally bred bananas given by narrow researchers. Tendo Sali, a banana breeder at Kawanda Research Center, weighs in on the debate.
You can relate it to what happens in the natural setting, where a male meets a female and then they conceive and then you get offsprings. Only that now, the breeder, I am in charge of the process. I choose the parents and then I evaluate the offsprings to see how they are performing. So we try to germinate them in the lab, give the embryo only all the nutrients they would need.
Hybrids have been in existence for over 17 years in Uganda. However, according to Dr. Andrew Chigundu, a biotechnology expert at NARU, some did not meet the preference requirements.
That led us to use and to develop new methods, modern ways of breeding.
The banana program is being run by NARU and a USAID-funded agricultural biotechnology support project too, supported by Cornell University in the US.
The problems in crops that cannot be rectified by traditional methods, normal breeding methods. For example, in banana, it's very difficult to breed, especially East African Highland banana, because most of the varieties are sterile.
Much as they support hybrids, they would like to start growing transgenic bananas.
We've taken genes from sweet pepper to create resistance to banana bacterial wilt in bananas. Other genes can be taken from other organisms, such as bacteria.
But there is a section of scientists, politicians and farmers who are against genetic engineering.
Spreading a lot of unfound and untrue information.
Many of these people that are opposed to genetically engineering have never been in an agricultural setting in their life. They don't have an idea what farming really is.
Because of the stiff flak against GMOs, NARU advised the National Council for Science and Technology to come up with a regulatory bill, which has since then been tabled in Parliament for debate.
Right now at Kawanda, we have developed bananas with resistance to banana bacterial wilt. We've developed bananas with increased vitamin A, developed bananas with resistance to weevils, nematodes, and the rest are going to come.
There are actually religious differences that say that, you know, we're playing God, for example, by moving these genes around, which, you know, is really not the case. A lot of people have a very romanticized vision of what agriculture should be. To them, it should be very rudimentary. It should be farmers out plowing or digging in the farm.
Bananas are highly demanded, and the Minister of Agriculture plans to increase the production by 30%.
In Acholi, the materials which are producing are the materials which we produced using conventional breeding, not biotechnology.
Even our proven process has not yet started because we don't have the law in place. So don't think that there is GMO out in the field. Not at all.
We are targeting release around 2020.
But before the GMO bill sees the light of day, hybrids remain an alternative for food security.
Unfortunately, we have 7 billion people on Earth right now. We're approaching 9.5 to 10 billion by 2050.
But the world is not expanding. How possibly can we feed all these people if we cannot take advantages of the technologies?
We only use genetic engineering where conventional breeding has failed to work. In fact, conventional breeding is our tool of choice.
However, the debate to introduce GMOs in Uganda remains combustible, with accusations that blue-chip companies in the West have dangled a carrot towards politicians and scholars to favor the passing of the biotechnology bill.
Which is also ridiculous.
Florence Nalimba, NTV.